caught up in the controversy over TMT are astronomers. Many at the University of Hawaii tell us they want to see the project completed at Mauna Kea. Sam Spangler spoke to one of them today and joins us now with more. Sam?
Lauren, I spoke with the director of the Institute for Astronomy. He believes the 30-meter telescope on Mauna Kea is the best instrument to answer one of humanity's biggest questions. Is there life outside of Earth?
The 30-meter telescope is different than any other telescope in its ability to study if exoplanets, which are other planets orbiting stars in our universe, are capable of sustaining life.
So that's kind of the holy grail, if you will, of that area of astronomy. Find another Earth around another star. And the 30-meter telescope facilitates this in a way that is not possible with existing telescopes because of the advantages I explained. The exoplanets are very faint, so you need a big telescope to see them at all. And also they're close to their parent star, and so you need a big telescope to be able to see the planet separate from the star.
Dr. McLaren calls Mauna Kea the top astronomy site on Earth due to its geographic advantages.
Its main advantage, though, is that because it's on a shield volcano out in the middle of a big flat ocean, the airflow over the mountain is smooth and doesn't become turbulent, and that means that the sharpness of the images is much higher than you can get at other locations.
The telescopes all work in concert with one another, making operations smoother if TMT is in Hawaii. But the concern over the alteration of terrain on the mountain is not lost on Dr. McLaren.
To reduce the overall impact of astronomy on Mauna Kea, it's been agreed that a number of observatories will be removed in the time frame that the TMT becomes operational. Those commitments were made as a form of mitigation in order to not continually increase the footprint of astronomy on Mauna Kea.
Dr. McLaren also pointed out that TMT will be donating $1 million a year to STEM education programs in Hawaii, and that the observatories power 500 jobs, many that go to locals and many that aren't astronomers. Lauren, we'll send it back to you.